Kia ora koutou, malo le sifua, kia ora ana, malo I le leile, bula vanaka, whaka alofa lai atu, ta aloha nei, ta lofa lava. Hi, I'm Neville Myers, Technology Facilitator at Te Tapuae o Rehua Consortium, University of Canterbury. This screencast is about technological products and specifically some key messages related to Level 1 product standard 91049, commonly known as 1.6, which is to demonstrate understanding of how materials enable technological products to function. This is part of a series that we as technology facilitators are doing covering the external assessment technological standards. AS91049 is derived from the technological products achievement objective from the NZC at curriculum level 6. So the starting point when understanding the requirements of 91049 is to look at what the curriculum says. What is the achievement objective at the curriculum level? What are the indicators of progression? And what other guidance is available to you? We suggest that you go to the technology in the NZC tab on the technology online. Click on the technological product section of the diagram, which you will see on the web page. You can find a summary of the key ideas about technological products, the indicators of progression, examples, and the related resources on this page. More specific information about technological products at curriculum level 6. We suggest that you go to the teaching and learning guides for technology available on TKI at this address and navigate to the technological product section for curriculum level 6, technological knowledge, simply known as TK 6.2. These pages provide teachers with support, information and guidance to develop their understanding of the indicators, the progression. There is some teacher guidance, context for teaching and learning, literacy considerations, resources to support teaching and learning, key messages from the standard, and the resources to support student achievement. The key messages here, the 2015 assessment specification states 10 A4 pages. If more are included, only the first 10 will be marked. Evidence to support this report must be put in the student's own words. Simply downloading does not provide evidence of understanding and therefore will not achieve. Students are to be encouraged to read through the teachers are encouraged to read through the students' reports and interact with the report before sending away. To ask questions of why, how, and what. This is to tease out more of their understanding prior to them sending it away. Some key points to consider when writing the report. Decide on the headings of the report. The introduction, the materials, the composition, the material structure, and the manipulation that has been performed. A suggested starting point is the use of the brief and specifications. Students are to identify the product or products that they have made over the year and identify the performance qualities that the products needed to be judged as fit for its purpose. This could also be the attributes of the product, such as absorbency, texture, strength, durability, flexibility, sturdy, weatherproof, stain-resistant, drape, etc. Students are to clearly identify the materials that they are reporting on. These should be related to their classwork. Students are to explain why they decided on the material and how these materials related to the performance criteria mentioned in the brief. It is recommended that an analysis of the brief, inclusive of the specifications, is undertaken to identify the performance properties of the materials that enable the product to be measured as fit for purpose. Here the student has identified the performance properties of the materials within the sweatshirt. They state where it keeps the student warm, mainly in winter, comfortable, easy care, iron-free, hold shape, life cycle is to be at least for one season. Other performance properties could be warmth, strength, flexibility, crease resistance, malleability, drape, form, durability, absorbency, colour, texture, appearance and sheen. Students are to be encouraged to explore the potential impact of selecting materials, evaluate each material against the required performance criterion of the product, relating their findings back to inform them when making product design decisions. At Achieved, the students are to be encouraged to clearly identify the materials that they are reporting on. These should be related to their classwork. The students are to explain why they decided on the material and how these materials related to the performance criterion mentioned in the brief. At Achieved, the student is to identify and describe the material composition of at least one material which made up a technological product. This can be using a diagram, list, or a written description. They are to identify and describe the material structure of at least one material which made up a technological product. This could be through the atomic structure, molecular structure, visual aids to demonstrate structure, or it can be a written description. They are to identify the performance properties of at least one material which has made up a technological product. This could be the flexibility, absorbency, or the heat resistance. They are to identify and describe the impact of the composition and structure of the materials on how the material can be manipulated, i.e. mixed, shaped, joined, combined, separated, or finished. They are to identify and describe the forms of manipulation that the student has applied to the materials. And finally, for Achieve, they are to explain the structure and how the performance properties of the material influence their decisions when making a product. Composition. Students need to be supported to explore to determine how composition and structure determine the performance properties of the material. Here, wood is this could look like. Wood contains three major chemical constituents, cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin. Cellulose constitutes about 40 to 50% of wood, and it is responsible for most of the wood's properties. Cellulose is a linear polymer, and wood cellulose forms bundles, which are called microfibrils. For textiles, cotton was easily dyed by, and then the dyeing was achieved due to the natural properties of the composition of the cotton. Rayon, the reasons for rayon having the performance properties of good drape is because of, and this ensures that these will all aid the child. Here, the student identifies the composition of the materials, which is in mild steel, describes how it can be manipulated, then provides the reasoning for its selection. Care needs to be taken to watch for students undertaking a copy and paste without the student's voice being evidenced to demonstrate their own understanding. To evidence structure, students can identify, describe, and explain the structure by using the microscopic picture of wood, showing the pores, annotated to evidence their understanding. What is essential is the commentary that describes and explains the picture. This is what is required. Just identifying by leader lines or a singular word does not evidence understanding. It could be that the structure of grain, the structure of cotton. The key element when writing the report is to identify and describe the structure. Then the student goes on to comment about how the structure is linked to their selection of the material and how the structure enables the product to be fit for purpose. Key messages at merit. Explain how the composition and structure of the material determine the performance properties of the material need to exhibit. Explain how the composition and structure of the materials determine the ways materials can be manipulated. So students are to explain how the material used and the way they have manipulated allowed the tech product or products to function as intended. Students are to present evidence of their interacting with the materials they are writing about in their report around the different, e.g., different types of flour used in making cakes they're able to go on to explain the simple terms of how materials and structures and composition determine the performance properties. It is essential that the students are able to relate their comments about composition and structure to their own projects. Key messages at excellence. Students are to discuss how the interaction between the composition and the structure and manipulation of materials enables the technological products to function as intended. Students are to be encouraged to base their reports around their own experiences, discussing how the materials used have helped their projects to function in the intended way. Students are to present evidence that compared and contrasted materials to predict the changes to products as a result of composition, structure, and the manipulation of the materials. Students are to present evidence that compared and contrasted their material or materials that focused on how the structure of their chosen material dictated how they could be correctly manipulated. It may be necessary to provide students with some sentence starters to enable them to begin their responses and tease out their understandings. Many students only need a prompt to enable them to evidence their understanding. A word of caution here though, ensure that these don't become a template provided to the students to use and only provided to the students to use where appropriate. Review of terminology, and especially of curriculum terminology. It is recommended that the teaching program revisit prior learning of how materials enable technological products to function at levels 4 and 5 of the curriculum. The following concepts are a prerequisite part of the teaching and learning program at years 9, 10, 11 to better prepare students for the standard. The standard does focus on the performance properties of the material and how these influence their decisions when making a product. Students are to consider how the composition and structure influence the decisions regarding the manipulation of the materials. The first of these is formulated. Materials that have been formulated has had two or more materials added to formulate a new material. This results in a different composition and structure. Forming involves bringing two or more materials together to create a new material that has a different chemical composition and structure and therefore different performance properties. For example, mixing flour and water and salt to make dough, mixing wood fibers, resin and wax to make a medium density fiberboard, MDF, combining glass fiber and polymer resin to form fiberglass or fiber reinforced polymer. Second of these is transforming. It is seen as changing the structure of an existing material to change some of its properties, but it remains the same material. Transforming involves changing the physical structure of particle alignment of a material and therefore some of its properties without changing its chemical composition. So, for example, felting, beating an egg white, heat treating a metal to harden or anneal it, steaming timber to soften its fibers so it can be manipulated, commonly known as bent. The third of these is manipulation. Here we have an example of how materials have been manipulated. Its composition and structure is not altered. Manipulation involves working existing materials in ways that do not change their composition and structure and therefore their properties. Manipulation can involve, for example, laminating materials, changing the shape of materials, and joining different materials together. It can involve cutting, molding, bending, joining, gluing, and painting are examples of manipulative operations. Plywood is made by laminating of timbers. This process is achieved by gluing the timbers together. Manipulation involves working existing materials in ways that do not change their composition and structure, and therefore their properties. Manipulation can involve, for example, changing the shape of a material or joining different materials together. Cutting, molding, folding are examples of manipulative operations. What is not important in the report or to the report? Students are focusing on growing and or harvesting of the materials, e.g. cotton, explaining how it's grown and harvested. This is not required. The report does not require the student to record unnecessary information about the history of a material, product or production methods, and stakeholder evidence that does not explain how the composition and structure influence how the materials are manipulated in relation to their project. This report is about how the material is manipulated and how the composition and structure affect the ability of the material to be manipulated in relation to their project. What is required for excellence? For excellence, if students are comparing and contrasting two different materials, they need to discuss how the interaction between composition, structure, and manipulation of materials enables the technological products to function. Only too commonly, students who are looking at two different materials are struggling to discuss the interaction between composition, structure, and manipulation. Their responses generally are only observed to be compared to the materials at a merit level. They commonly do not go in depth on either material enough to get excellence. Please ensure that you access the key NZQA documents each year, as these key documents can change from year to year. Please make sure that you read the assessment report each year to make sure that your advice to students is up to date. Look at the most up-to-date exemplars on NZQA website at this link. Read the marker's comments in the yellow boxes. And if you share the exemplars with your students, think of deliberate activities to do with your students using the exemplars rather than just providing the link to them. Suggest that you encourage the students to identify the structure of the report, or have the class reflect on how the student has talked about their own practices within the report. Good starting points. This is part of a series of we as technology facilitators are doing covering the external assessment standards. The others done to date are 1.5.91048, the modelling, and 1.10, achievement standard 91053, design elements. They are available along with other webcasts and PLD resources on our technological wikis at these addresses. And this brings us to the end of this short presentation. So in closing, I want to acknowledge that the extracts from the student work are from the 2014 exemplars, 91049, published on the NZQA website. If you wish to clarify anything in this presentation, please contact the facilitator in your region. Thank you. Ka kite anō.